आदित्य पाटिल फ्रॉम बीके बिरला कॉलेज. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिगार्डिंग बर्नौलीज प्रिंसिपल. दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉज कंडक्टेड इन आवर फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बीके बिरला कॉलेज. फ्लाइंग बॉल इज अ वंडरफुल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ बर्नौलीज प्रिंसिपल. हियर आई यूज्ड अ ब्लोअर टू फ्लो अ बॉल एंड ड्यू टू हाई प्रेशर द बॉल रिमेन फ्लोटिंग इन द एयर इन स्पाइट ऑफ इट टिल्टेड. You can see here how the ball floats. Same experiment was conducted in our physics department. Here we actually made two balls to float in air. Now we are actually going to understand what is Bernoulli's principle. Let's see ahead. Bernoulli's principle was invented by Daniel Bernoulli in 17th century. He published his Hydrodynamics in 1738. His study was in fluid dynamics. Same phenomena was further used for flying object, for example, a aeroplane. Introduction. In fluid dynamics, Bernoulli's principle states that increase in speed of fluid occurs simultaneously with decrease in static pressure or decrease in the fluid potential energy. The principle is named after Daniel Bernoulli, who published it in his book Hydrodynamics in 1738. Although Bernoulli deduced that the pressure decreases when the flow speed increases, it was Leonhard Euler who derived Bernoulli's equation in its usual form in 1752. Bernoulli's principle, simple definition. An increase in velocity of a fluid that is accompanied by decrease of pressure. Swiss scientist Daniel Bernoulli in 1700 to 1782 demonstrated that in most the cases the pressure of liquid decreases as the liquid or gas moves faster. Floating ball experiment is a wonderful example of Bernoulli's principle. As we have seen in videos that were conducted in our BK Birla College, we found that the faster air flows over the surface of something, the less the air pushes on that surface. The air from the hairdryer or blower flows around outside of the ball, and if you position the ball carefully, the air flows eventually around each side. Gravity pulls the ball downward, while the pressure below the ball from the moving air forces it upward. This means that all the forces acting on the ball are balanced and the ball floats or hovers in mid-air. Stability of ball during flight. As you move the blower or hair dryer, you can make the ball follow a stream of air, because the Bernoulli's principle says that fast moving air around the sides of ball is at lower pressure than the surrounding stationary air. If the ball tries to leave the stream of air, the still higher pressure air will push it back, so the ball will float in the flow no matter how you move. The pressure in the flow is lower than that of the air surrounding the ball, and the ball is pushed up in the direction of air flow. Because of the high speed air passing near the surface of the ball, it also spins and its height of flying varies continuously. We can also float more than one ball at the same time. Real world application of Bernoulli's principle. Aeroplanes can fly because of Bernoulli's principle. The flying of the aeroplanes is based on this. Air rushing over the top of aeroplane, which I mean is that the air which is flowing above the wings of aeroplane exert lower pressure and as compared to the air which is flowing under the wings. So relatively greater or higher pressure below the wings supply a upward force or lift that enables the aeroplanes to fly. Various other applications of Bernoulli's principle. First, Bernoulli's principle can be used to calculate the lift force on an airfoil if the behavior of the fluid flow in vicinity of foil is known. Second, carburetor used in many reciprocating engines contains a venture to create a region of low pressure to drop fuel into the carburetor and mix it thoroughly with incoming air. The lower pressure in the throat of the venture can be explained by Bernoulli's principle. Third, an injector and a steam locomotive. Fourth, Bernoulli's principle is used to calibrate the airspeed indicator so that it displays the indicated airspeed appropriate to the dynamic pressure. Fifth, Bernoulli's principle is also applicable in swinging a cricket ball. Yes, the Bernoulli's principle is also used in cricket. During the cricket match, bowlers continually polish one side of the ball. After some time, one side is quite rough and the other side is still smooth. Hence, when the ball is thrown, the bolt and the passes through air. The speed on one side of the ball is faster than on the other side due to the difference in the smoothness, and this result in the pressure difference between the side. This leads to the ball rotating, swinging, traveling through the air, giving an advantage to the bowler. Wow, it is wonderful. Bernoulli's principle is also applicable in cricket. Principle of flying ball. Here, as we see earlier in the videos, that two balls can also be flied at the same time. The principles acting on the ball are lift, which is upward, gravity or gravitational force due to weight, which is downward, thrust, which is also, and drag and lift. Lift and drag are considered aerodynamics forces because they exist due to the movement of aeroplane through air. Please, if you interested the topic, please like and subscribe the video. Thanks for watching. Press the bell icon for getting new information. Thank you.